We always go too easy.
Huh? Can I help you?
She-Ra.
Greetings.
Move along.
Walk blessed, my sir. How can Sylvan and friends serve you today? Would you like to open a personal vault? Or perhaps even acquire an estate? A ledger. Your very own safe in our house, which we will manage on your behalf. We will meticulously track all your deposits and withdrawals, and best of all, thanks to our very generous interest rates, the longer you entrust your money with us, the more it proliferates on its own. Well, evidently this was a metaphor. Just imagine that for every day your money rests in our vaults, we present you with some extra coin on top of it, as in appreciation for your trust, so to speak. Well, you see, this is a highly complicated process, and I fear it would be a matter of near impossibility to elucidate my response in such a fashion that you would be capable of comprehending it with your, I beg your pardon, most likely quite limited intellectual capabilities. Let us talk about more enjoyable matters instead, such as your money. Fine, then. We use it to trade. We invest, for example, in promising expeditions or new trade routes. And from the returns those investments yield, we not only pay our employees, but your interest as well. Now, don't you look at me that way. We have to make a living somehow, too. Prince, do not make mistakes. Didn't your parents teach you this? Now enough of this nonsense and back to business. Do you want to open a gold shelf or not? Very well. We will need a 100-penny deposit to start with. After that, you may make a withdrawal or deposit whenever you would like. Excellent. You will not regret this. Here, this is your personal safe key. This way, you may access your shelf even when we are closed. To make a deposit, simply talk to one of the bankers or put it on the shelf yourself. Ah, and should you acquire any shareholdings, simply give them to me and we will allocate them with your future interest. Well, holdings for something, a business, a caravan, things like that. But forgive me for saying so, you do not seem to be a man of means, so I don't suppose it will be relevant to you. Of course. Penny pouches. So that old man found himself a new errand boy, did he? Show me. Yes, this looks solid indeed. Here is your money. Walk blessed, my sir. How can Silwyn and friends serve you today? Of course. Of course. A wise decision. Of course. Walk blessed! And don't forget, your money is safe with Silwyn and friends. Exceedingly safe, believe me.
Monsieur?
Hear my words, O path-abiding people of this holy city. A miracle has happened.
My sir?
That must have been.
Walk blessed.
Yes? Now, if it isn't the hero of the hour. Word of the stunt you pulled with those petrified got around. Mael Doloran himself wishes to see you. I strongly assume he's planning to hire you as a protector. Congratulations on that. Oh, you did? I'm impressed. Particularly since he's the grandmaster of this guild. In the guild house, just on the other side of the street. Now hurry, he doesn't like to be kept waiting. If that's what snappy sounds like to you, maybe you should consider a change of profession. I heard the bathing house is still looking for harlots. Oh, there is no problem. At least not a problem that needs resolving. Let me put it this way. I'm impressed by how you, without a moment's hesitation, use the tragic events at the caravan site for your own advantage. But I guess that's just how this world works. Business is business. Forget about it. You wouldn't understand even if I told you. Walk blessed.
Some shifts never end.
Oh, hello. I haven't seen you around here before. Just take a look around and tell me if you see anything you like.
You're the guy who found the caravan, right? Go on in. The Guildmaster is waiting for you.
Take a seat. Good. Thank you for coming. I'm Mael Delorin, by my path, Guildmaster of the Golden Sickle. What is your name? Well met, I'll be frank. You're an outlander, and that makes you pathless. And I'm sure you know by now that the Golden Sickle is more than just a band of merchants. It's a citadel of traditional values in a time when they hardly exist anymore. Still, I believe that everyone has the right to prove themselves, pathless or not. And when you fought those assassins, you did just that, even though you were too late. So, as promised, I'll make it short. I want to promote you to the rank of Protector. That sounds just like him. You know, there were times when Mindalus was young and full of ideals. But his behavior these days continues to remind me that those times are long past. I suppose he thinks your promotion is unfair to the other recruits. But you're fit for the task. Even he should see that. It does. But the circumstances are anything but ordinary. How? With floors made of marble and statues of gold? This is not a brothel for nobles. It's a place of work. And in my experience, that kind of nonsense does one thing above all else. Distract. The same as working for the trading post, only you will no longer have to waste your skills on running errands. You promise to honor the principles of the Golden Sickle, and to never act out against it or its members. In return, you will be granted a good pay and path-abiding honest work. Work that other outlanders would give their left hand for, if I may say that. You don't have to be. You help the sickle when it needs help, and you get paid. That's it. Good. Can you read and write? Excellent. This contract contains what we expect from you in written form. Read it, sign it, and then we can start. Yes? Excellent. Then we can start right away. Are you ready for your first assignment as a protector? Before I tell you, I have to ask you something. Are you familiar with the Blue Islands Coalition? The Blue Islands Coalition is a league of powerful merchants from the Belt of Kilay. I take it you've heard about the civil war on Kilay. It has been going on for 2 years now. Recently, the Council of Elders, which is made up of mostly wealthy merchants in Kilay, succeeded in restoring rudimentary order. That is, if a dictatorship by those cutthroats can be called order. Blasphemous rumors about the supposed death of the Lightborn. It's ridiculous when you say it out loud like that. But the Kilayans never were a god-fearing people to begin with. I suppose some of the elders were behind those rumors. They wanted all the power for themselves, so they spread a rumor that the gods were dead, and that it was time for a new order to arise. At first, it was just a few remaining servants of the Lightborn against the usurpers. Then the latter started turning on each other. Thousands of people died. Although the Kilayans brought this upon themselves, it's still a tragedy. It affects trade. Since the Civil War, the prices for spices, cane sugar, and Kilayan cloth have exploded. And while some might profit from this, most merchants don't. But this situation should settle down now that the war is over, and it's not the topic of this discussion. I need you because some days ago an emissary of the Blue Islands Coalition arrived in Ark. Yes, but it's no ordinary visit. We'll talk of that later. I don't. But that's a different story. I want you to meet this emissary and give him this letter. It's a written invitation to come to the Guild's house for dinner. Well, finding that out will be part of your job. But I suppose he's somewhere in that city where there are colorful clothes and shining jewels. Kilayans are drawn to that kind of flashiness like children to sweets. Now go. Come back to me once you've delivered the message.
Hello.
You just have to work if you want to achieve something. That's just how it is.
Hello.
just don't see the fucking point.
Yes?
Tender friends of the granulous pleasants melt away in rapture.
He no talk to Dool. He no bad. Talk to others. Emissary. He talk about the jam? The jam not here. The jam other place. Perhaps Dool can remember, but he needs to help his memory. Dool's memory old and full of holes. Like cheese. He right, but sailor life is rough, and the sea winds blow with thoughts just like that. Dool heard that pennies can help, but Dool not knows if true. Oh, he wants fight. Dool knows fight. Show Dool what you made of.
He won! Dool want no pain. The Jam went bathing in house with many waters. He go look there. He has what he came here for. Go now. Leave Dool alone.
Mead, stew, roast pork. Anyone?
He has what he came here for. God.
Yes, you should go into the Whisperwood and see what you can find in the old fortress. I'll wait for you in the Undercity, in my laboratory. Yes, you should go into the Whisperwood and see what you can find in the old fortress. I'll wait for you in the Undercity, in my laboratory.
My sir? They just sit on their asses and hope things settle themselves. Idiots.
Yes? Yes? What are you doing here? Yes?
Oh well.
You just don't know their place in the world.
Potion to cure red madness. Wouldn't that be something?
Walk blessed, has my sir come to indulge in the hot springs of the Larkses? Or is my sir simply looking for a place to forget about life's daily sorrows? In either case, he will be required to pay a toll of 57 pennies. Unfortunately, a man with such a name is not known to me. Or is my sir simply looking for a place? Oh, my dame, you should cover yourself with...
Let's talk downstairs, shall we? I want to indulge in these beautiful springs for as long as I can. It does. Come on down. Is it important? What is it? Are you coming? So, I take it you're the welcoming party from the Sickle, am I right? I was told someone would contact me as soon as we landed, but for the past 2 days, no one has. I thought I might as well take a look around the city. Even though this city has certainly seen better days, at least according to the gossip. Red madness, lost ones in the forests, crazed brigands. Phew! I'm sure they have their reasons. I have. But I've been warned that this Delorean is a... how shall I say... a complicated character. I'm important, and I'll let you feel just how important by letting you wait. But who cares? Once an idiot, always an idiot. Now, aren't you curious? But fine, why not? We want to buy an artifact from the Sickle. An ancient and powerful one. One of unmatched value. Two golden testicles from a Vatir, each of them weighing 3 pounds. Sorry, I just had to. Jokes aside, I would be a bad merchant if I went around gossiping with confidential information, wouldn't I? Don't take it personally. Show me. Formal supper in the guild's house with Delorean himself. Oh my. This is going to be an evening full of jesting and good humor. You can tell Delorean I'll be there. Thanks for delivering the message. Charming.
Ah, one more thing before you go. You're Inal. I've heard that accent before, but I just can't put my finger on it. Where are you from?
Of course, that was it. And how is it that a traveler like you is now running errands for the Golden Sickle? Uh-huh. Anyway, good luck with whatever you do next. Ah, and if you're in the mood for it, Apparently there's a Calaean minstrel group in this city, and they perform in the tavern just next to the bathing house. I'll stay there for the time being, and I wouldn't mind a good chat. Now, aren't you subtle? Then walk blessed, as people here like to say. Hello.
Yes?
Is it important?
Well, there comes a point, and you just have to live with it.
Hear my words, O path-abiding people of this holy city.
The fish you seek, they come and
many
take
of you may have heard it.
Yes? 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 She? Oh, wonderful. That changes a lot. Not if they understand the meaning of responsibility and discipline. And unfortunately, that's not the norm. Now you'll get your pay. Go talk to Penny Pouches. I will contact you if your services are needed once again, which will most likely be very soon. Farewell. There's one more thing. This Dijam. What's your take on her? Most Calaeans are, as long as it serves their ends. Now go. You'll hear from me. Yes?
Of course. Your pay for having a chit-chat with that woman. Here, I think that is more than enough. Well, aren't you the eager one? Was all that money whet your appetite? But no, not at the moment. Oh, hang on. You know a thing or two about beating up people, don't you? Well, there might be something. Landlord Boric recently complained about rats in his granary. And we agreed to send him a ratter. That would be a job for you, wouldn't it? I can't do that.
Guildmaster DeLorean sent me. It's about this new protector. Do you know where he is? Of course, sorry. It's just... I didn't know what you looked like. Master DeLorean wishes to see you, my sir. At once, he said. It seemed to be something important.
Why? What's this about? The caravan?
Forgive me, my sir, but I don't know. Master DeLorean asked explicitly for the new protector.
Uh-huh. Then it seems someone else has to take care of the rats. Off you go. The Guildmaster doesn't like to be kept waiting.
My sir?
Yes? Yes?
The best wine in all of Enderal. Come, give it a try.
Yes?
Hello.
Huh? Now look at that. It's the prodigy. Now look at that. Someone who's actually interested in us as people, rather than in our knowledge about the Pyreans. But it's your lucky day. I really wouldn't mind a good talk right now. Hold on a second. Arizalian brandy. Vintage 8214. What do you say? A glass and a good talk? There are a couple of things I wanted to ask you anyway. All right then. I hear you say that, I don't regret for a second that I never came back to Ostian, even though I've thought about it from time to time. Wow, finally, someone who says it up front. Yeah, I've got some Scarak blood in me, though comparably little in regards to how much it shows. My grandfather, he used to serve in the South Realm's Marines, and one day they captured a ship of Scarak raiders, some of them women. Stories say he fell in love with one of them, and... yeah, you can connect the dots. But to answer your original question, yes, I'm from Ostian. Though we fled the city around 10 years ago,
the right choice, as I probably don't need to tell you. The temple was always a bunch of fanatical fuckheads, but that bastard High Priest Janus gave the word butcher an entirely new meaning. I know, and nah, I hardly know anything about her. Only that they were raiders and that she fled about 2 years after giving birth to me. Poor Grandpa. You should have seen how people reacted to the way I looked. Even as a kid, they always looked at me and my almond-shaped eyes as if they were expecting me to pull out a skull fetish any second and start putting curses on anyone in the vicinity. Maybe. Warriors of the Creator. War against the infidels. The Creator's children don't even sugarcoat how radical their faith is anymore. And still, so many people join their ranks. It's fucking insane. But then again, I guess that's religion for you. Don't think for yourself anymore. Let someone else do it for you. At least it was for my brother. I had. He was about 15 years older than me, and was always a troubled child. Rakul, that was his name. You know, my family was very wealthy before we fled. Drapers for generations. The best in Ostia. I suppose that's why my father expected so much from Rakul, since I, as a woman, wouldn't have been allowed to take over the business when my father would have retired. But Rakul, he just wasn't made out for it, you know? He was shy and introverted, and never had a hand for money. I can't remember how often Father told him that he was a disgrace to the family. You can call it that, yes. Looking back, I think the temple only gave him what Father wouldn't. A perspective. The feeling of being needed. He spent almost all of his time in the temple after his conversion, and knew the entire Rania, their holy scripture, by heart. Well, in one day, he announced that simply attending the masses wasn't enough anymore. He would join the temple's warriors. Damn right. That's what these bastards do. They exploit the vulnerability of people like him and indoctrinate them with their fucking bullshit. And once that's done, they send them to fight for their holy causes. In other words, their own interests, like pawns on a chessboard. And if they die, then they call it a fucking honor. I'm sorry, my dame. Your youngest son just died. But don't worry, he's in a better place now, eating grapes and drinking honey. What solace, isn't it? Now, do you have any other neglected children for us? We're running short on material. Damn it, I hate those bastards. I just hate them so much. He was slaughtered, hacked into pieces by Chancellor Baratheon's cavalry. That was before the peace treaty. I'd be surprised if they taught him what end of a lance to stab with before they sent him into the field. But, well, I guess that answers the question you asked me up in the temple, doesn't it? I was sick of seeing people using religion for their own ends. Creator, Lightborn, the Great Spirit. Same shit, different name. And you know what? No matter how much chaos the death of the gods caused, I don't regret being a part of it, not in the least. It was the right thing to do. Anyway, I'd say we call it quits for now, okay? It was good talking to you, but I'm dying for a nap. Take care.
Now, look at that. You came. Didn't think you would. So, what's your take on this contemporary sample of Kilayan dancing? You think so? I've seen better, but she's not bad, that's true. Anyway, how about a sip of wine? Rounds are on me.
Fine vintage.
Come, take a seat.
Luck blessed.
So, before we move on to more pleasant topics, there is one thing I need to get off my chest first. I heard of the, paper chase you had to go through to find me. I know, he's pulled that stunt on others before. He speaks perfect Nail, by the way. That whole, I only stupid Kilean thing is part of the act. In that sense, thanks for teaching him a lesson. It was overdue. But anyway, tell me, what brought you here? Just where exactly from Nerim are you from? I'm curious. That's why I asked. Yeah, I know what you mean. You know, this is precisely why I find it so interesting that so many people accuse us Kileans of being greedy or dishonorable. I mean, just take a look around. Are the other nations of the civilized world really so much better? We've got Nerim, which was recently split into three and devastated by three madmen. I don't need to tell you about that. Then there's Kira, with its fabled free thinking in universities. But every 2 weeks, there's a new attempt at revolution with at least 36 corpses. And don't get me started on Arctwind, Arazael, or this place. What I'm trying to say is, yes, there's poverty on the Blue Islands. On Kilei, and yes, there are problems. But we are free. Neither Morala nor the Elder Council tell us what to do. And no matter how dire the circumstances you're born into, life is what you make of it. So it's basically the opposite of this excuse for a country. Anybody can become rich, famous, or if they want to, live an eremite's life on the beach. As long as they can go through with it. Then sure, there are exceptions. But in my experience, those who never made it brought it on themselves. I know. That's why you're different from the rest of the people here. You know, I know what it means to have to fight for something. Unlike that snot Delorean, I wasn't born with a bag of gold stuffed up my ass. But instead of wallowing in self-pity or listening to the priests talk about how everything gets better once you're dead, I took responsibility for my own fate. If a dust-sniffing loser as a father and a clump-footed, half-witted brother qualify as not exactly noble, then yes. I don't want to talk about it. Was. Merciful as the gods were, they blessed him with a deadly fever at the age of 10. Probably better that way. An addict and a failure. Do you know the kind of person who does nothing all day long but whine about how unfair the world is? Take that and throw in 2 sacks of drogue and there you have him. Geron O'Nalis, my esteemed creator and one of the reasons I spent most of my childhood eating dust and insects for breakfast. It was. I have, and I'm only getting started. You should see them, all these losers who I grew up with. Yes, they were dealt a tough hand, but instead of grabbing fate at its throat, they just went through their lives with their heads bowed and nodding at everyone. I'll never understand how people can be that way. Anyway, let's not go further into this. I'd say we make a cut here, shall we? It's late, and I should see how my crew is doing. It was a pleasure, Protector. Until next time.
Yes?
So many strange faces. Well, isn't it nice?
Oi, what, who are you, and what are you doing with that beautiful barrel? That is as nice as you know, but I think today is your lucky day. For 50 pennies, I will forget what I saw here. What? That's not how this works, you know. Just wait until the others hear about what you did.
Huh? No.
The best wine in all of Enderol. Come, give it a try.
Oi, what, who are you, and what are you doing with that beautiful barrel? That is as nice as you know. Of course not. What are you thinking? Thanks a lot.
Huh?
Yes? What are you doing here?
Hymn of the Desert King.
An outlander. Isn't this nice?
Monsieur?
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. I can't wait to see what that stupid innkeeper has to say about the Rivervale Ale after tonight. Here's your reward, 40 pennies. And, as promised, a paper that marks you as a shareholder of the brewery. That should keep you motivated to stay silent about this in the meantime. Not a chance. Sorry. Talk to Samael Sildren in Sildren and Friends, the bank. He will make sure you get your share of the brewery. Now, walk blessed. There's a lot to do.
Walk blessed, my sir.
Hear my words, O path-abiding people of this holy city. A miracle has happened, a miracle that must have been, due to its sheer glory, brought forth by Malphus himself.
Apples!
Tilor Arnfield has returned! Yes, you have heard right. The lost heir to the throne, son of Glorious, has, after decades of time.
Hello, how may I be of service? Of course. You do? Let me have a look. Very well, this looks solid. We will add any future gains from this holding to your vault. Walk blessed, my sir. How can Sylvan and friends serve you today? Of course. Walk blessed! And don't forget your mud. Safe with Sylvan and friends. Exceedingly safe, believe me.
You're an outlander, aren't you? I can tell. Tywin Summerfield. By my path, accountant of Screws, Hats, Odds and Ends Incorporated. Even though I doubt the two of us have common ground, so to speak.
Yeah. It's not as if I didn't tell them that already.
Fruits, vegetables, bread.
Doesn't matter. Maybe I'm mistaken. You don't know this. How can I explain? We are an association of thinkers. Highly gifted thinkers of Starling origin, to be precise. And Screws, Hats, Odds and Ends is our guild, to put it in worldly terms. Ah, and did I forget to mention that we are the number one supplier of the Holy Order in terms of metalware and Starling technology? Work? No.
If it's clam and fish,
that is... Maybe yes. You do get around quite a lot, don't you? You certainly look like it. Fine then. I suppose it's worth a try. There is something in a person of your talents could come in handy. A grand-scale assignment we recently took on. One of our customers ordered replications of several Pyrean artifacts. A most exquisite wish, of course, any of our people could fulfill. However, our current problem is that we still need many of those artifacts' originals to work with. If you could recover those originals for us, you would be generously rewarded. Here, these are some of the ruins that might be worthwhile visiting.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls.
Sorry, but this is none of your concern. Splendid. Come back once you've found something.
Apples, dates, bananas, the freshest fruits right from the Farmer's Coast and Duneville.
Still on the road at this hour of day? I think I have just what you need. A flight right to the next inn.
And if I am, what is it to you? Listen, I know you mean well, but not now, please, not now. Huh, help. Who are you, Lorem Waterblade reincarnated? Aye, maybe you could help me, but I think we both know what that really means. You want money. Everyone wants money. It's all that keeps this bloody world moving. That bastard Gulfer proved it. I shouldn't talk like this to you. But still, please, just let me be. Just go.
Show me. Now look at that. I have to admit, I'm surprised. How would you like to be rewarded? Fine. Anything else? If not, please leave me to my work. Until next time. Maybe.
Can I help you? They always go too easy on the scum.
What? Work. Did you say something?
Life isn't easy.
No. I'm perfectly fine. This is a grave, and I'm kneeling in front of it.
Yeah.
I couldn't be better.
As if I didn't tell them that already.
I'm sorry.
Well,
you didn't deserve that.
A pleasant surprise.
I just...
It certainly is.
I don't know whether I'm coming or going.
How are you faring?
Fine. My sister,
and you?
Gadia.
I have never been better. Thank you.
She... I don't know if you've heard about it, but there was this incident in the temple. The Red Madness. And you've heard about it. My sister. She was a novice, just as I am. And she...
Scarag leather, you say? What has become of this world?
You know,
exactly, my dame.
She met this boy.
Exactly.
He was only of the manufacturer's path, and neither our parents nor the Holy Order would have approved. She wanted to leave the city with him, travel the lands, just like in the bard songs.
Someday, I most certainly will. Walk blessed.
I called her a fool. I told her that it was our path to serve the Order. And that leaving here would be a sin. 3 days later, it happened. She sat in the first row in Euro. You know.
We always go too easy on this.
You say it as if it were far-fetched. But it is my fault. Without me, she would be with that boy in Dunville. Building a new life. It is my fault she was in the lecture that day. No matter how I twist and turn it, this is how it is. Easy for you to say. Anyway, I should go back to the temple. Thank you for your words. Walk blessed.
Yes?
Greetings. Hey, bloody wench thinks she's Vata incarnate.
Another snob from the
Sith.
Soon.
Boring.
Hey!
Foreigners.
You're an adventurer, aren't you? Have you been to... Oh, how do they say it? Melee? My dad told me that's where the petrified live.
Move along. Pity. He was a good man.
You're not from here, are you? I heard... Keep walking.
So many fights, so little money. You
have to pay for it. Bloody vermin, all of them.
Orpheus, my sir, please.
You don't look like you belong here.
From the upper city, huh?
Yes.
You got guts walking around with all that stuff.
Ranma Rasha's home for lost kittens. Honestly, if you need to ask, then you sure as fuck don't belong here. Go back to your bathing houses and galleries, sunchild.
You can do this.
Ooh, how eloquent. You're from the surface, aren't you? No, don't say anything, I can tell. No cave dweller gets that much sun on his pretty face. So, you want to fight, huh? Oh, you're the sneaky type, aren't you? That look in your eyes. The constant twitching in your fingers. I can tell. Fine. Why not? I don't care about style. As long as you can fight. You do know that we're not doing tumbles down here, right? If you fight well, you can make a lot of money fighting here. But if you don't, well, you can imagine. Usually, yeah. Sometimes the loser pleads for mercy. But the crowd doesn't like it. Oh, sure. Sometimes they even come down here and read us quotes from the verses. Jokes aside, I couldn't care less about what the Order does or doesn't know. Down here, the rules are different. Well, for what it's worth, I don't particularly enjoy seeing some baby-faced boy have his head taken from his shoulders either. But these are the rules. And if the stakes weren't as high, everybody would join the party in hopes for treasure. And frankly, for some people, the pit offers a chance at something they wouldn't find elsewhere. The chance for a better life. But I don't think you, as a sun child, would understand. Huh. All right. First of all, you'll need to sign this, though. If you can read and write, sign with your name. If not, with a cross. Thank you. Then we can start right away. And, one more thing. I always found this a bit silly. But the crowd always wants a name they can shout to the ring when you're bashing someone's head in. You know, the fighter, the butcher, stuff like that. So, what do you want? Great. Really. Fair enough. If you want, you can dive right into the ring. There'll be a pack fight in a couple of hours. Yeah. Also called Last Man Standing Wins. 3 to 6 fighters in the ring. Dog eat dog. Well, that depends on the bets. So I can't tell you yet. But if you win, it'll be well worth it. Tell me when you're ready to fight. What do you want? Eager, aren't you? Good. Just go down to the training dummies. I'll call you when we begin.
Welcome to the Dust Pit! You know who I am, I know who you are, and above all, I know why you are here today. Because you want to see a fight! Today, there are 4 rookies in the ring, and they all share the same dream, to become the champion of the arena. Ah, can you see them shiver, the sweat glistening on their foreheads? They are afraid. And rightfully so, because they know only one of them will leave the pit on both legs. Mesdames and Messieurs, I proudly present Kata Tanner's daughter, called the Storm. Simael Roth, called the Vagabond. And Thomas Shagar, also known as the Derwin. And last but not least, the unknown warrior who is only known by his moniker, the Destroyer. Now, enough of the words. Fight! Blazing blazes, what a punch!
If we don't get the money until tomorrow, there will be consequences. So handle it.
But... fine. I'll see what I can do.
Good girl. Relata Shera. Well fought.
Ah, you. Well fought, really. Here's your share. Pardon my language, but none of your fucking business. Well, aren't you a piece of work? Still got blood and dust on your skin and already begging for the next battle. Come by in a couple of days and ask again, will you? I got things to take care of. So long.
So many fights, so little money. Move along. Thank you.